Hello and welcome to the second video from our free trading lessons for beginners. This is the team of DM Trading Bulgaria. Last time I told you a little bit more about me. My name is Valentin, but now let me present you my colleagues. This is Ilian. Even though we are illustrated here, you can have at least a rough idea who we are. So this is Ilian, he's a trader and coach at DM Trading Bulgaria, and his area of expertise are the Forex market. And this is Seba, he's our social and community manager, and basically he's responsible to do all the checkings and posting for all the content that we are providing for you. So, as you can see, today we are at section 1, terminology and basics, and today's lesson will be about chart dissection. During this lesson, I'm going to talk you through what is chart, what it is representing, type of charts, and of course a lot more. So let's get to it. So what is a trading chart? Well, the simplest definition here is that this is a visual representation of price movement for given security in certain time frame. Here on the right, you can see the most popular colors for any trading chart. Here, what I can tell you more is that the green bars here that you see are usually representing when the price of a certain security is going up, and the red bars that you're seeing here are representing when the price of the certain security is going down. Now, let me show you a real chart on which you can visualize this a lot better. So, as you can see, this is a real trading chart, and of course, I think we saw this chart once before into the previous lesson, but now let's get to the main point. As you can see, the green bars are representing when the price is going up, and of course, as you can see here, the red bars are representing when the price is going down. So what's next is type of charts. Here what you should know that I'm going to explain you the most popular one of them, but only one of it is most commonly used. First is the line chart. You can see it here, and from what you can see from this small chart is that all the movement that the price is making for a certain time frame are represented only by one line. Next is the bar chart. You can observe it here on this second small chart. And the first thing that you can notice is that again you can see red or green, which is representing when the price is dropping or going up. And of course you can see as well the places where the bar chart opens and where it closes for the certain time frame, of course. And last but not least is the candlestick chart. You can see it here, it's the third one, and it's the most commonly used chart into the trading sphere. It looks like this, and the movement, the price movement, are represented by these so-called candles. But in the next slide, I'm going to talk you through more about what is a candlestick and how it is formed. Of course, there are other types of charts as well, but I'm not going to talk you through all of them now. I'm just going to show you some of them on the real chart. As you can see here, we are at the moment for the candlestick chart. But as you can see, we also have something called Hayakin Ashi. We have also hollow candles. We have areas, which is some sort as an add-on to the line chart. But as I already said, the most commonly used one is the candlestick chart. So, what does the chart represent? As I already told you, the chart is representing the price movement for given security for a certain time period. But what I haven't told you yet is that with the charts you can also spot easily the formations and the levels from which the price is reacting. But for this we're going to speak more about into the second section and the technical analysis. Now let's continue with the next slide, and it is candlestick chart. And here I'm going to talk you through more about how it is formed and what exactly it is representing. So about the formation of the candles, as I already said, the most popular colors are green and red, which is representing when the price is going up and when the price is going down. So, what is a body and what is a tail? This part, which I'm showing to you now, as you can see it here and here, is the body, and the small lines here and here are the tails. Here, what is important to remember is when the candles is positive, or with other words green, this is the level or the price on which the candle opens, and this is the level, or of course the price, on which the candle closes. When the candle is green, always the opening level is below the closing level. During the movements for given time frame, and actually for time frames we are going to speak more about into the next slide, very often the price is going below or above from the levels from which the candlestick opens and closes. These levels and actually these movements of the price are actually forming the tails. As I already told you, these are the lines for the tails. For the dropping candle, or with other words, for the red candle, it is pretty much the same, but upside down. Whenever we have a body with red color, this is the price or the level on which the bar opens, and this is the price or the level on which the candle closes. Again, the price movements which are below or above the opening and closing price are forming the tails. So now we're going to speak more about time frames. The time frames are representing the price movement for a specific time period, and of course they are representing from candles, bars, lines, whatever you choose. It doesn't matter. Here what's important to remember is that they are representing the price movement for a specific time frame. Here on the right you can see another type of chart, and what I want to tell you now is that with the specific time frames you can very easily spot and differentiate the movements of certain security for a specific time frame, let's say minutes, hours, or maybe even days, weeks, it doesn't matter. You just choose and check whatever you need for your strategy. The most popular time frames for quick trades, or with other words for scalping, are between 1 and 5 minutes. 1 hour and 4 hour time periods are for swing trades, and of course there is a daily bar or daily time frame, which is for more long-term trades or maybe even investment strategies. So how are they used? Well, the trend and formations, for which actually we're going to speak more about again into the second section, technical analysis. So these trends and chart formations from a lower time frame are very easily stopped from those from the higher time frame. This is due to the fact that the signals on higher time frame are always stronger than the one on lower. And apart from the chart formations, they are also used to determine the continuation of a given movement. And now I'm going to show you this on a real chart. So this is again the well-known chart of the US index S&P 500. But now if I switch to 1 minute chart, look what happens. As you can see, all the smallest movements are represented here on the 1 minute chart. And if you want to follow some specific movement, the chart formation and actually the candles are going to show you, and I'll tell you more about this in the next lessons, how much of this movement is already exhausted and how much of this movement can be catched for your future trade. And the last slide is about the market working hours. Here, I just want to show you first some of the major markets and in what hours they operate. As you can see here, this is the most famous New York Stock Exchange. And as you can see, it works from 9:30 to 4 o'clock in the afternoon. These are all local times, so if you want to see them, how they are working, I advise you to check them in comparison of GMT time. Here, of course, you can see some of the other markets. This is London Stock Exchange. Of course, here the working hours are different. They are working from 8 to 4 and 4:30. What's interesting here is that some of the exchanges, as you can see, most often from the eastern part of the world, as you can see, Tokyo Stock Exchange, they have a lunch break, which is from 11:30 to 12:30. This is, as you can see, very uncommon for all the other markets. And we can see the same thing for Shanghai Stock Exchange. They have, again, from 11:30 to 1 a lunch break. What's interesting here is that you can see that the Frankfurt Stock Exchange, or in other words, the Deutsche Börse, they are working from 8 to 8, which is quite uncommon. And of course, there are other markets that are working relatively less time, as let's say Australia, from 10 to 4 into the afternoon, and Dubai, which are working from 10 to 2 in the afternoon. So here, first let's talk about type of markets. What I want to tell you here is that some markets, as let's say Forex, they are working almost 24 hours a day and 5 days in a week. So there are movements constantly compared to other markets like, let's say, equities or commodities, where actually they closes, and this is very important for you to know, because these closes and big gaps of time frame are actually forming gaps on the actual market and on the actual chart. And this is very important, as I said to you, to know, because sometimes the price is reacting very strongly on these so-called gaps. But we are going to speak more about this into the next lessons, where we are going to examine in more details the chart formations. As you can see from the previous table, the different regions has different working hours. And of course, what is very important here to know that all the different markets, because they're representing from different countries, they have also different holidays. This is, in my opinion, very important for you to know, because if a certain market is closed, let's say because of a holiday or because it closes earlier than the others, this could affect very much the liquidity of a given security that you're trading, and respectfully, this will affect your trading. And of course, the different sectors has a different specification as well. Here I'll give you just a quick example. Let's say the crypto market, it's working 24/7, which is making the trading there very differently from all the other markets. So that's why you have to follow all the sector specifications as well. This was everything about this video. I hope you liked it, and I hope this lesson was very helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and of course to click the little bell, because in this way you're gonna be notified immediately when we post a new video, and you can take advantage from it. For the next lesson, we are going to continue of how to open your first trade. Thank you very much for your attention, and till next time. Bye bye.